Hey, good morning, Top Fans. Bill from Top Fan Rivalry here with another edition of the Top Fan Rivalry Clubhouse. And this morning, I have the pleasure of having Michaela on in our Clubhouse today. She is an Astros fan. Yes, a Dodger fan is interviewed an Astro fan. This is going to be so much fun, I tell you. But I'm so happy to have you. Thank you for joining us.
Yes, thank you for having me. I'm super excited.
Good, 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 good. So obviously we know that your favorite team is the Astros, but but do tell, do we have an experience? Do we have something that made that be the case? Or is it just a hometown thing?
So yeah, definitely. I had actually moved to Houston. And when I got there, I decided after a couple of years after dancing on another team in Houston, I was going to audition for the dance program for the Houston Astros. So I did that for 2 years, and then I became a baseball fan. I had gone to over 250 baseball games in those 2 years, and it was a great experience for sure. So definitely at first, I'll be honest, I was not a huge baseball fan, but then after being there and just really, it's such a family atmosphere, I fell in love with it.
Yeah. Yeah, so last night on a podcast that I did, we were talking about ballparks and things like that. And one of my, the person that was on, we had mentioned Houston as a ballpark that we both wanted to visit. So yeah. I'm sure you fell in love there. That's awesome.
Oh, yeah.
So tell me, do you have a favorite player?
I do. It's kind of a tie, to be honest, between George Springer and then also Jose Altuve. I still get upset that Springer isn't with us, to be honest, but you know, you gotta do what's best for you. But, I love Jose Altuve, both like,
gotta get the money, right?
Yeah. You gotta do what's best for you. It was heartbreaking though. Me and my mom were like, I don't want to believe it.
Yeah. Being a Dodger fan, I understand this. I mean, Corey Seager left, right? For Texas, for Arlington. Right. And so, it's been tough to watch this the free agency. So what makes these two guys, do you still watch George, even though he's not?
Not as much, to be honest. When I did, I really followed him, you know, just so much as far as when I worked there. And then I just loved watching him play for the Astros. So I watched a couple games here and there of him, but it's just not the same. Okay. As far as with like Jose, I just love how he is as a person, like, you know, on and off the field. He's a leader. He's definitely someone who, he does so much for charity, and he's a humble guy. He's not someone who thinks that he's too good to give you a high five or, you know, talk to you or anything like that. So for me as a player, like, or for my favorite player, it'd definitely be him, just because I mean, someone who's okay being like that and just talking to anybody and getting excited to talk about anybody and not feel like they have a big head just because they're one of the best players out there.
Yeah. I watched a documentary with him. I want to say the MLB channel did something a couple seasons ago where he goes home every offseason and works out. And this little guy, this 5-foot-nothing guy, is lifting these big tires. And this workout that he does, I'm looking at him, I'm going, this dude, how is he doing this? This tire is bigger than him. And so yeah. did you see that documentary? Do you know which one I'm talking about?
I've seen a ton of videos of just him. Like, he's my mom's favorite player. And so anytime that there's like a video of him, like, she still tags me on Facebook. Like, yeah. It comes across it, I'm like, I've already seen it. Thank you, Mom. But I've seen a ton of his stuff. I'm a huge fan of him for sure.
Awesome. I hear that a lot around there.
I think if you're not even an Astros fan, you're a fan of him. I mean, he's just a good dude.
he plays the game for the most part. I mean, I know that there was the 17 issues and stuff like that, but he plays the game. He reminds me a lot of Dustin Pedroia, who used to play for the Red Sox, where they just show up. They're not the biggest guy physically, but they show up and they just play the game right. And you don't hear about him, you know, going to do stupid stuff after the game or anything like that. You know, he just plays the game right, and he's a good dude. I like it. Okay, so super jealous. I'm sure plenty of people that are going to be listening to this are going to be super jealous that you've attended 250 games in such a short period of time. But tell me about ballparks that you've been to. I know you're not a huge baseball fan. You became one, but have you visited any other ballparks besides for Houston?
So actually I haven't, to be honest. I've only gone to a couple minor leagues. Like I did the Corpus Christi Hooks because we had to go over there and work for our caravan. And then I've done the Sugarland Skeeters in Houston. I've done like minor league ones just because we had to go and volunteer our work over there. And then obviously our San Antonio Missions over here. Mm-hmm. But yeah, no, as far as like major league, I have not. Definitely the Ranger Stadium is on my bucket list. As far as anything else goes, I want to start with that one just because one, it's the closest, and two, it would be fun just to watch the Astros play them. So yeah, definitely I would like to go to a bunch. I just haven't done it yet.
So besides for Texas, what do you have any other stadiums that are kind of bucket list stadiums?
Probably, I don't know, as far as just like Florida, maybe. I don't even know. Like, honestly, I wouldn't be picky just as long as I could see the Astros play another team somewhere else, to be honest. So, yeah.
So put on your bucket list Fenway. At some mm-hmm. point, get up to Boston. That okay. is the most unique stadium because it's in the middle of a neighborhood. Like, oh, legit uh-huh. in the middle of a neighborhood because it was built in the 1900s, right? So okay. strange how it's built. Mm-hmm. Get up to Yankee Stadium. I mean, that's just fun.
Yeah.
And it's because of the rivalry, because of 2017, if you can ever make it out to LA, get out when the Astros play the Dodgers in LA. You'll enjoy that stadium. The view behind the stadium is like of downtown LA. It's just picturesque. Pretty awesome. Pretty awesome.
Oh, nice. That's awesome.
Tampa Bay, if you ever get down to Tampa Bay, it's the weirdest stadium you'll ever go to. Sorry, Rays fans, if you're listening to this. It's like this big dome, and it's a white dome. Half the mm-hmm. time, the players can't see the ball in the air. They're kind of like looking up, going, where's it at?
Oh, gosh.
Awesome. That's awesome. Okay, so when you were on the dance team, were you on the dance team during the World Series?
Yes, so I was. Oh. I was, my rookie year was the year before, and then my last year was during the World Series. So I was okay. captain during the World Series. So
super okay, fun. So tell me about that World Series experience. I mean, that was, be kind. Remember, I'm a Dodger fan. Be not. No, I'm teasing. But tell me about that, and then tell me about this year's World Series.
Oh, gosh, it was a super surreal feeling. I mean, my rookie year, we didn't even make playoffs. So from going from that to going to the World Series and then winning it, it was just beyond crazy. I mean, even just as far as like my rookie year, you could go to a game and maybe like half the stadium was full or something. And then going to where it was sold out and standing room was insane. The energy was crazy. But during 2017, that was when we had Hurricane Harvey, so it was just a devastating time for Houston. And honestly, just it was really what the city needed whenever we came back. That was the first real big event that the mayor allowed happen, and so that was just a crazy experience. So being able to do that, and then a couple of those girls are still some of my good friends, being able to share that experience with them. My mom came to one of the World Series games, so that was super exciting to do that kind of alongside with her as well, share that experience with her. And then obviously getting my World Series ring too. I never wear it, but, you know, just something to have and keep. I did take it out though for this year's World Series, which I felt really weird. I was wearing it at a bar over here, and I went with my mom, and then I was like, this seems weird, like I shouldn't be wearing this. Like, it just was a little bit much. I was like, when are you gonna wear it else time? You know,
exactly. You earned it.
It was definitely, you know, one of the best experiences of my life, and I still cherish a lot of those memories that I made.
You know, it's funny that you say that about the ring, because your kids, your grandkids will get mm-hmm. a chance. You can tell them about that experience. Hey, I was mm-hmm. there during the last time the Astros won the World. No, I'm teasing. I was there I was there when the Astros won the World Series in 17. Now, that's phenomenal. That is such an experience. Now, how does the city of Houston respond during the playoffs? Is it kind of like a, you know, we're all about it type thing?
It was crazy. I mean, well, for one, it had never happened where we went to the World Series. So when that happened and we clinched that, I mean, you could feel the energy everywhere. Leaving the stadium, a couple blocks from the stadium, people were like honking their cars, hanging outside their windows, going crazy. It was a blast. I mean, that whole month was just, you know, crazy fun. But yeah, I mean, like, definitely. There's a lot of what you would say, like, bandwagon fans, but, you know, like, hey, come on board type of thing. But
come on, let's go.
Yeah. At the same time, though, it was just really cool because it was such a polar opposite experience, because from my rookie year, people were Astros fans and it was, you know, oh, yeah, like, they supported it, you know. But then, like, the polar opposite of then they were, like, diehard Astros fans. So, yeah, it was fun.
Awesome. I love that. I love your experiences. I mean, you've got experiences that others will never have, which is awesome, right? It's awesome. So, okay, so final question for you as we wrap up. So what are you looking forward to? Fingers crossed that the CBA is okay and we get baseball back on. What are you looking forward to the most next season?
Honestly, just really watching Dusty's leadership. I felt like he was really a joy to watch, and I really liked how he went with the whole how we're going to do well is because he loves the players and they love each other. And as corny as that sounds, I mean, like, really baseball is a wholesome game and it's very family oriented. And I like how he leads his team, and he definitely an example. So I just really enjoyed watching his leadership this past season, and I'm anxious to see what he has in store for us. So, and I'm hoping that some of my other players will stay. So, so hopefully no one else leaves.
Carlos Correa is being shopped just about everywhere.
Oh, you said it.
Yeah, he's being shopped everywhere. In fact, the Dodger fans, because of 17, have a special kind of, and there was an article not too long ago that says, could you accept Correa and Dodger blue? And it was like a poll, and it was not very nice. I'm like, no, just keep him in Houston. They love him there. He'd be great there.
And I'm just like, he needs to stay there. Like, he started there as a baby. Like, please just stay there and finish out. Like, so I just hope he doesn't end up leaving, but you never know. I mean, you never know.
Yeah, I there's a lot going on in the offseason. I sure hope that it just mans itself and it holds, you know, it down. And hopefully the Astros in the 70s and 80s weren't always the team to be reckoned with, but now they've become a force to be reckoned with, and it's starting to become good for baseball when they're good. I mean, it's good for baseball when the Yankees and Red Sox are in it, and, you know, when the Cardinals are in it or the Dodgers are in it, you know, some of the big market teams. But now it's becoming good when the Astros are in it too.
Yeah, for sure. And it's more enjoyable for you to watch a game that you're like, it's not an easy win. I mean, for any fan, you don't want to watch something where like, okay, well, they have it in the bag. Like, I'm not really invested now. Like, they're already so high up. Like, but yeah, no, definitely they're in the big leagues. They're one of the big dogs.
I love it. Well, I appreciate you coming into the clubhouse and talking with me for a little bit. You are welcome back anytime. We can do this again when the season starts. Sometimes we get together a bunch of ladies and just have a ladies' night where they talk. The last one we did got kind of funny, actually. We were talking about favorite players and things like that. I had a lady on who says she's a huge Mike Trout fan, and she's from Orange County area. Okay. And so she sits in center field and she'd yell, get baseball ready. So Mike Trout would like bend over and she'd like, okay, here we go. That was it got a little weird. So anyways, but you're welcome to come back anytime. This has been great. I love hearing from different fans, especially fans that we haven't had on before. So thank you.
Yeah, well, thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
You bet. So top fans, make sure that you like, make comments on this. If you'd like, we'd love to have more comments and love to see what you think, and we'll take it from there. So Michaela, thank you for joining us, and let's do this again.
Yes. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.